The brothers, who have unveiled a statue for Princess Diana, were pictured together ahead of the poignant ceremony. It was first time brothers have seen each other face to face since Prince Philip's funeral in April, and the pair seemed to be in good spirits while enjoying each other's company. But body language expert Judy James claims Harry was filled with inner tension during the unveiling, which one clue gave away. Harry's hand reached to touch his wedding ring, which is a self-comfort gesture suggesting some inner tension. Although it also hinted how much he sees his family as a source of support. Royal authors Katie Nicholl and Robert Lacey agreed that yesterday's statue unveiling could provide the first baby steps for the princes to repair their relationship. Princes William and Harry's joint statement paying tribute to their mother as they unveiled a statue of her could be the starting point to repairing their relationship, royal experts have said. The brothers came together yesterday on what would have been Princess Diana's 60th birthday to reveal the statue at Kensington Palace, which depicts the late princess surrounded by three children. After, the pair released an emotional tribute to Diana where they said they wish she was still with us and that they hoped the statue would be seen as a symbol of her life and her legacy. And speaking on a special Facebook Live edition of True Royalty TV's The Royal Beat, royal authors Katie Nicholl and Robert Lacey agreed that the brothers releasing a joint statement was a positive move and could provide the first baby steps towards a better relationship between them. Katie said, "We were initially hearing that there would be separate speeches and then there wouldn't be speeches as it wouldn't be appropriate, so I think a joint statement was the perfect solution as it suggests symmetry, it suggests togetherness. I think the simple fact is that Diana would be devastated that the brothers have fallen out. She would have hated it. She said to the boys, whatever you do, stick together, and they haven't. They've come unstuck. But today, I think this statue represents a glue that will begin to heal. It's going to take more than just this to heal the rift, but there has to be a starting point in the getting back together process." And Robert, author of The Battle of Brothers, added, "What could be a better starting point than this? They are both there to pay tribute to and reflect on their mother and what she stood for. A week ago we were being told about separate speeches, but how much better to have a joint statement that represents what they both think, and this makes a starting point for both of them. Harry's pleased to be back in England, on his own home territory with his family. I think we can read positive vibrations into what we've just seen. Obviously, it's not going to be a total reconciliation, but I think it's its first baby steps towards some sort of new arrangement in the future. There's no way the Queen would have put up a statue to Diana, obviously no way Charles would have put up a statue to Diana, so this is them. It's the new Spencer generation taking over. There's not a Windsor inside here, it's that side of the family." Meanwhile, Ingrid Seward, editor-at-large of Majesty magazine, who also appeared on the program, said the brothers were not going to let their rift get in the way of yesterday's event. She said, "There's no way they were going to let anyone steal the thunder from their mum and the statue, so they were very, very anxious to keep control of this. They were definitely not going to let us know if things were awkward. I don't think it's the moment to try and have a rapprochement. I think it's very difficult when you haven't spoken to a member of your family for some time to suddenly say, well, right, let's make it up. It's sort of unsaid, especially amongst the royals. They're not the greatest at this kind of conversation." But despite William and Harry appearing in good spirits with each other, Robert claimed their relationship will not be fully repaired anytime soon. Referring to Prince Philip's funeral, he explained, "We were told by friends that the moment they were out of sight of the camera, they were at each other's throats. We are dealing with deep-seated emotions here." William is defending his view of the monarchy and the royal family and how he thinks it should behave and how he thinks Harry and Meghan together have disrespected that. For Harry's part, he is defending the wife he loves against a family that he has said is even being racist in its attitude towards her. These are very deep-seated emotions, and they're not going to be papered over quickly. In the joint statement released yesterday, William and Harry said, "Today, on what would have been our mother's 60th birthday, we remember her love, strength and character, qualities that made her a force for good around the world, changing countless lives for the better. Every day, we wish she were still with us, and our hope is that this statue will be seen forever as a symbol of her life and her legacy." Rumors of a rift between the brothers first surfaced early in Harry's relationship with Meghan Markle and peaked when the Sussexes sat down for a tell-all interview with Oprah Winfrey. In their chat, the couple claimed that a senior royal asked questions about Archie's skin tone and Harry accused his brother and father of being trapped,